The Honourable Member for Minto.
Madam Speaker, Canadians from coast to coast to coast are concerned about the federal SNC-Lavalin scandal. The evidence strongly suggests the Prime Minister removed the former Attorney General from her portfolio because she refused to bend to his wishes to direct federal crown attorneys to avoid a criminal prosecution of a Quebec-based company. It's extremely upsetting to learn about efforts to discredit the former Attorney General. This included putting into the public domain details of an application to the Supreme Court of Canada by a well-respected and experienced Manitoba judge, Mr. Justice Glenn Joyal, who is the Chief Justice of Manitoba's Court of Queen's Bench. Mr. Justice Joyal felt compelled to respond to the media stories and in fact shared personal health information about a family member to explain why his application was withdrawn. These efforts to discredit the former Attorney General expanded to reveal that the former Attorney General planned to elevate former Chief Judge of the Provincial Court, Judge Ken Champagne, to replace Mr. Justice Joyal in the Queen's Bench. I have the utmost respect for both of these judges. I know they've worked to improve the justice system outside of any political or ideological bias. It is shameful that the integrity of the application system for federal judicial appointments has been breached and has taken a backseat to crass politics by federal liberals at the highest level. Manitoba's Minister of Justice has chosen not to comment on this. However, the Manitoba Bar Association and legal experts in Manitoba and beyond have condemned the politicization of the application process and the chilling effect on those who may wish to apply in the future. I add my voice to those who condemn the efforts by those in the federal Liberal government who have ignored the collateral damage of their campaign. It is a sad day when a Prime Minister and his supporters, trying desperately to hold on to power, choose to try to discredit a Cabinet Minister who resigned on principle. Manitobans and Canadians deserve better, Madam Speaker.